juicy to the hitter, and nothing more frustrating when you miss that pitch and you pop out. He's going to have to think about that till his next at bat.
Two outs, base is empty. Next for Colorado, Peter Bruce. And that's in there at the knees for a strike. And a swing and a miss there.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
That one missed.
He missed the zone, but I don't think he missed his spot. That was a good pitch with two strikes.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Clifford hauls it in to end the inning. Bottom of the inning, and here is Sam Means. And first offering is fouled off. Gets a piece and stays alive. The 0-2. Swing and a miss, and he got him. Picks up strikeout number 7.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
That one's in there, and it's 0-2.
He's controlling things out there on the mound, not messing around at all. He's been in attack mode since the very start.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Boog, if you can set up a good two-strike splitter with the fastball on the previous pitch, it's going to be so tough to recognize and adjust your swing to get a piece of it. Clearly had him reaching for it right there.
And first offering is fouled off. Ball one there. Swing and a miss, and that's strike 2. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Nothing doing for the Rockies. They still find themselves down. Set for the last half of the 7th. Digging in, Rich Moreno. There's a strike.
This lineup is having a tough time finding a good rhythm at the plate. Their swings are disjointed, which tells me they're having issues with pitch recognition.
Can't connect on the curveball. Struck him out.
Well, that's such a critical pitch in terms of execution right there. The pitcher has to finish it. Otherwise, probably gets hit pretty hard. If you leave that out over the plate or you don't get it down enough, quickly turns into something that gets smoked. But if you can place it where he did, it's a really deceptive pitch.
One down, base is empty. That one finds the zone. 0-2.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with a mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
Two outs, base is empty. Next to hit for the Rockies, Drew Gilbert. The bit behind with that swing. It's strike 1.
Hey, 7 straight strikes to start the frame. He's got a chance at an immaculate inning.
The Rockies hitless so far in the game. Swings and misses. 3 up, 3 down, inning over. Back here in Denver, here's the shortstop at the plate, Colin Hout. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Mooney drifts towards it, reaches over the wall, and he's got it! Jermar Johnson digging in for the Rockies. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Langoliers makes the grab, and there's 2 away. 2 outs, base is empty. Peter Bruce will hit next.
Now this guy is just filling up the strike zone right now. Don't want to get yourself in an 0-2 hole. You better be ready to pull the trigger on the first pitch.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Back here at Coors Field, all set for the bottom of the ninth. So in now for Colorado, Sam Means.
Right through there for a strike.
Boog, I'll tell you right now, every player defensively on their toes like never before.
Ball one low.
They want to make sure they have the opportunity to put this pitcher in the history books. They're going to make the play.
Struck him out looking. He's two outs away. Johnny Ramey, the next to hit. That one finds the corner, and that's strike one. Base is empty, one away near the last half of inning number nine. Bounced up the middle. Tosses to first. Gets the catcher by a step.
26 up and 26 down. One more out for a perfect game. This is awesome, Boog.
On the verge of baseball history here, and certainly one of the most dominating pitching performances we've seen. Everyone locked in right now.
I mean, his pitch efficiency, ability to get ahead in the count, at times pitch to contact, let the defense work behind him. That's why he's still in the game here in the ninth inning.
They're down to their final strike. You just don't see it that much anymore. A guy being this efficient and get swing and a miss. Got him. A perfect ending to a perfect game.
Just unbelievable. I was nervous up here in the booth. I can only imagine what his teammates and even he felt out there on the mound closing this thing out. Everyone will remember this perfect game, and it'll be notched in Cooperstown forever.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Miami Marlins, 6 runs.
Steven Tan, the next up for the Marlins.
Steven Tan.
There's a swing and a drive. That one back there. Back gone. He leaves the yard to right. His 38th of the year. It's 2-0. That adds another game to his hitting streak, Chris.
Yeah, he's been doing so many things well at the plate and clearly driving the ball with some authority as part of that. He's really dangerous with the bat in his hands right now. He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrists to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
Next to hit, Andy Smooth.
The first baseman, Andy Smooth.
Still only one out here in the inning. Double play ball to second. Flips for one. And that's two. They get two and draw even again. We head on now to the top of the third. We are tied 2-2.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Steven Tan.
Here's a high fly ball out to center. Gets under it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Next for Colorado, Tanner Suecos. Tied up here in the early going. Out to short, Tan. The throw to first, and the inning is over. 1-2-3, go the Rock. That one is absolutely belted. Forget it! Another homer. His second home run of the game, and the Marlins jump out in front. It's 3-2. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off.
We'll do you one better than a tape measure by breaking out the numbers from StatCast. The distance, 450 feet on the dot.
Oh, my goodness. And that's one, Boog. You're going to see it making the rounds on social media all night long.
Now it's the shortstop, Stephen Tan. He's got a couple homers already, so can he possibly do it again?
Come on, man. Of course he can. Those two he hit were legit, and he looks pretty locked in right now at the dip.
Cortez back to work. That's a laser base hit. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
The pitch. Here goes the runner. That one out to right. One away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
And up next for Miami, Brian Benitez.
Back, back.
Snap throw to first. Tan back in on a dive. Right through there for a strike. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. That's it for a strike. Throw to second. Save. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris. Runner goes again. Ball misses. Throw to third, and he's out.
Yeah, I don't really get the logic right there of trying to steal third. You've got to count where that hitter's.
So two down, and now the center fielder, Drew Gilbert. On the ground to short, Tan. Out to escape a bases loaded jam. Two outs, runner on first. Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Stephen Tan. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. And it's into the bleachers, out of here. And he's gone yard again. Home run number 40 on the year. It's 7-2. Singy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. He's putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now.
Tan really stood out in this win. Three homers in this one, just amazing.
I'll tell you, Boog, I was excited every time he came up. When a player is locked in like he was, it's a really special feeling. Great job in this one.
Here now is our final line score for this afternoon.
Stephen Tan, the next up for the Marlins.
Stephen Tan.
Warning track. Whoa. and you can touch them all, baseball man. A gigantic blast. That's his fourth home run of the series, and it gives him the lead in the first. It's 1-0. Singy, he's got a nice hitting streak going, and he extends it another game with that swing.
So locked in right now, Boog, and clearly it's not like he's just stringing singles together during this streak.
Well, Singy, you know I'm a member of the Nerd Herd, and these are the moments I really appreciate StatCast the most. We need to know how far that one flew.
Well, I'll tell you, over 500 feet, Boog, and that's just insane. And I know we're seeing more and more power in today's game.
Colin Hout digging in for the Rockies. Singy, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. On the ground, left side, 6-4-3, double play, and the inning is over.
They made it look easy.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That one carrying. That's long gone. A massive home run. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. And they add to their lead. It's 2-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now.
The cutter up and in can be such a tough.
And now for the Marlins, Steven Tan. And the way he's going in this one, we've been waiting for his spot to come around again.
All right, listen, everyone, stop what you're doing right now. This guy's got 2 home runs already. Now he's going for number 3.
Howard back to work. Clobbered to right field, way back, gone. Another homer. That's his 3rd home run of the game. And they tack one on the board. It's 3-0. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. He's putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one. And he's just so locked in with this swing. And he's just not missing right now. 3 homer game. Man, it's so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him.
And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the 6th. And now the DH, Rich Moreno. Righty delivers. On the ground. And it's through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
The third baseman.
Now, Steven Tan, and a chance to make some history here, Chris.
Yeah, he's homered 3 times so far, and now he gets another chance, at least we think. We'll see if the pitcher gives him anything to hit. It's so rare to see a 3-homer performance, but even more special for that player to get another chance at the plate to do it again for 4.
And that one hammered way back there. And out of here.
Wow, this is awesome. I mean, a 4-homer game, they're just so rare, they're so special, and just so tough to pull off as well. Everything has to line up for you.
And we're back to the batter now, Termar Johnson. And here comes. Out to short. Tosses to first, and they get the leadoff hitter in the 7th.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball.
One down. Sam Means digging in for the Rockies. At the belt and fires. On the ground, a 2nd, might be 2. Good feed, that's 1. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over. Still in total command on the mound with 7 shutout innings. It's the Marlins 6 and the Rockies nothing.
Looking for your pitch here. Let's go.
Smoke to right side. center, and this one's gonna go out of here. That was blasted to the moon. His fifth home run of the game. It's 9-1. That one just sounded different.
And might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I could feel that swing from the booth. Unreal. Absolutely unreal, Boog. I mean, this is an all-time. Oh, this is a nice sweep. Good way to finish this series. You're heading to another city for another one. Got to maintain the same focus. Whatever you were doing in this city, make sure you're doing the same thing in the next one. Eat the same thing, sleep the same way, get to the ballpark at the same time.
One error, they left nine runners on base. For the Rockies, four runs on 11 hits. No errors. They left 13 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 45 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
But I think I lost my mind. 11 runs of the same routine. Keeping up this facade.
Hello and welcome. Thanks for two outs, bases empty. Steven Tan, the next up for the Marlins. Warning track. Whoa! And you can touch them all, baseball man.
With a low 90s fastball.
Runner at first with two away. Ronnie Mauricio now. Bounce to the left side. Tan. They get the force, and that ends the inning. And welcome back to the ballpark. Now it's the power speed combo. Steven Tan. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. A gigantic blast. His second home run of the game, and they add to their lead. It's 2-0. That's his third straight game with a homer, Singy.
This dude is on fire, Boog. These kinds of streaks just don't come around too often. Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch him from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the...
Sliced hard but foul.
This is one of those situations the infielders have to pre-plan and understand that the ball's got to be hit extremely hard right at them if they're going to have a chance to go for a double play.
Smash to center, way back, and you can forget it. Home run. A massive home run. That's his third home run of the game, and they tie it up. It's 4-4. The brighter the lights, the more he shines.
Yeah, this guy.
Steven Tan will hit next. 3-for-3, and he's homered 3 times. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. It's a double, his fourth hit of the game. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
The pitch. He's trying for third. There's a ball.
Down.
Save.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Brian Benitez, the next up for the Marlins. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Green racing over to make the catch. Throw behind the runner, and they've got him doubled off.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll, and that's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Players start hitting up and down the lineup. You never know who's going to come up with
the pitch. Line drive. Come on.
Sometimes you want to be aggressive early in the at bat.
In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and gone. That was blasted to the moon. That's his fourth home run of the series. It's 3-0. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off.
Power versus power right there.
One down. Alec Thomas, the next up for the Padres. On the ground to the left. Tan. Gathers and throws to first. That's it out. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Green ranging back. And caught on the warning track.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear.
One out, base is empty. Steven Tan, the next up for the Marlins. He's already homered in this game. Ripped into right center. Should be extra bases. And he's into second base with one away as the go-ahead run. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that
runner takes off for third. Base hit around third. He will score, and they take the lead. It's 4-3.
He went up there and got it with two strikes.
Tan made a big contribution despite the loss.
Really impressive work at the dish. He gave his teammates a lot of opportunities in this one, even if they didn't cash in enough to get the win.
Next to hit, Steven Tan.
Steven Tan.
Hammered. Base hit. Lead runner around second to third. Lead runner holds at third, so two runners in scoring position and just one out. And his hitting streak continues. There have been almost no bad days for him in the past month.
This guy's running hot, Boog, and people around the league are paying serious attention to this.
Runner breaks for third. Base hit, one run is in. Another comes in to score. It's 2-0.
Everything came together for him.
So the batting order turns over. Fernando Tatis Jr. to hit here. Three balls, two strikes the count. Grounder might be two. Tan. The throw to first. That's one out, the bottom of the second. That one ripped right center field, and no one can get there. Shaw, round second on his way to third. Headed for the plate. Relay to third, and he's out. But a run does score, and they've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. That one ripped. Pulls it in on the warning track. Runner tags at second.
Now, we'll see if moving up to third there pays off for him. He didn't have to tag and go, but...
And at first, here's a big power threat. Steven Tan. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Good pitch right there. Anytime you can get one by a bat of this caliber, especially with runners on, it's got to give you some confidence out there in the mound that you can win this battle.
Swings and blasts one deep to left center. See you later. A shot to the opposite field. Home run number 50 on the year. It's 10-7. And that's his fifth straight game leaving the yard.
And Boog, if he goes a game or two without hitting a home run, he's going to feel like he's going to get sit down to the minor leagues. It's like he's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run. To the slight opposite field, into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
So one out, nobody on. Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Adael Amador. On the ground to short. And they got him.
He's out. Up next for the Padres, the center fielder. Oh, my God. Leading off for the Padres.
Here's some real power at the plate. Steven Tan. Back to the sixth. He drove a two-run shot out of here to help them get the lead they're working with.
Yeah, definitely one of the bigger moments in this game so far, and it could be one we look back on when this game is over as well.
Line to left. Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. The throw into second. The tag, and they cut him down, going for two.
This is a huge win to take this series on the road before heading back home. You go home feeling good about yourselves. You've got some good momentum. But at home, you also have a higher expectation to play well, so they're going to have to maintain the focus because those fans are expecting a lot.
Ready to sleep or not?
Yeah, you okay?
Huh?
I gotta get sponsored by Elder Bear, bro. The little plant. You know
ready to sleep or not?
I
said, are you ready to sleep?
Ow. I was thinking, can we postpone out our siege trip?
Yeah.
I kind of want to go to Perth with that there.
Yeah, Ali, just don't talk about it now, maybe, okay? It's a whole lot, I don't know the case here, go to.
Okay. So either we don't have to go next March, we go somewhere else.
And welcome in, everyone. Two outs, nobody on. Luke Gould, the next Pirate to hit.
I don't want to talk about the
trip. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Fires over to first. And that is that. Nothing doing here for Pittsburgh. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score.
And I don't want to waste money.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's a big power threat, Steven Tan. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. Now the right-hander ready to go. Still no score. Out to center. Classe gets under it. hauls it in, and there's one away.
He was all over that first pitch fastball, but just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready.
The batter, number one, Kristoff Steven Tan.
That one ripped right center field.
Hard.
One hops off the wall. Should be extra bases. Flint coming home. Now a relay to the plate. He'll score, and they trail by one. And that extends his hitting streak yet again. This is starting to get pretty interesting, Singy.
Yeah, and the way he's going, it seems like there's no end in sight. This is a guy that no pitcher wants to face right now, especially with runners on base. I mean, he's doing all the little things right, and it just seems like he's in cruise control at the plate.
Runner takes off for third.
Runner, you're scoring.
Base hit into the outfield. Tying run is in to score from second. We are tied at two. Now the tag at second, and he's out. Trying for two. Long throw is there. That ends the inning. They get two and draw even again. We played four. And now the catcher comes up to him. Donnell Corona. The wind of the pitch. Ripped to short. In plenty of time to first. And that is the inning. And 1-2-3 go the Pirates. Score remains 2-2. And we're back. And now Steven Tan. And here it comes. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. His 51st home run of the year. It's 3-2. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off.
An absolute missile off the bat, Singy. And StatCast gives us the exact numbers.
Yeah, it was a blur leaving the park, Boog. 114 miles per hour on the exit velo, man. Put such a great swing on that ball, squared it up, and just drove it out.
Here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Steven Tan. He's already homered here in this one. Out of line, out towards center. Classe makes the play. Runner tags at second to third, not in time. And it's runners at the corners with one gone.
He was all over that fastball right there. I tell you what, if he gets under it,
Tan was a big contributor for them in the win.
Well, they may want to change how they approach him next time because he was just incredible in this one. He looked like a threat every time he came up.
Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Pittsburgh Pirates taking on the Miami Marlins. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. Steven Tan, without a doubt, he's the man to keep an eye on, partner. He's homered in six straight games.
Well, Boog, he's just unconscious when you look at the ability to get to the baseball and hit it over the fence. I think about recent occurrences. Paul Goldschmidt in 2019, Matt Carpenter in 2018, and Giancarlo Stanton in 2017.
So up next, Donnell Corona.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field. But he can jump you if you make a mistake. For whatever reasons, this is a hitter that performs better in night games. We'll see what he brings in this one.
Schartner on third. Shanuel on at first with two down. Out to short. And that is the inning. Pirates strand a couple. Now the Marlins will see what they can do. No score. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here at Lone Depot Park, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Stephen Tan. The pitch. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. A gigantic blast. His 52nd home run of the season, and the Marlins jump out in front. It's 1-0, and the streak is alive. He's homered now in 7 straight.
Who does this guy think he is, Joey Votto or something? Man, that's ridiculous. When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity, he was all over that fastball.
Back to the top of the lineup, David Shartner, the next Pirate to hit. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game.
Boog, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
On the ground to short. Throws to first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. 3 runs for them here, and they move ahead to the bottom of inning number 4 now. It's the Pirates 3 and the Marlins 1.
The batter, the shortstop, Steven Tan.
Warning track, ball, and you can touch them all, baseball man. A massive home run. His 53rd homer of the year. It's 3-2.
See a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at bat. You watch him from the on deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
Man at first, and a batter now, Orelvis Martinez.
Orelvis is hitting for that pop. Came out of the gates really strong.
Martinez, 33 years old, and he won a gold glove last season. On the ground left side, 6-4-3, and they turn the double play.
Got what he was looking for on the mound right there, and his infield.
In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and gone. That was blasted to the moon. His 54th home run of the season. Just like that, they move in front. It's 4-3. Singy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he has really seen the ball well in this one. Putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now. A 3 homer game, man, it's so special, and I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
Next is the designated hitter, Nolan Schanuel.
Well, with pretty good speed over there at first base, I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down, hold the ball a little bit, step off, just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base stealer.
On the ground left side, 6-4 three. And they turn the double play.
Well, almost any time you roll over and send a two ball to short at this level, you can pretty much count on a double play. Middle infielders are just so reliable, and they work on these plays all the time, so it almost becomes like second nature.
So two down, Steven Tan, the next up for the Marlins. 3-for-3, and he's homered three times. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. It's 4-run Tan. Really excelled in this one and contributed to the win. Smashed three homers at the plate.
Well, they may want to change how they approach him next time because he was just incredible in this one. He looked like a threat every time he came up.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Steven Tan.
That's shortstop.
Schroer back to work.
Tan.
There's a swing and a drive. That one is gone. Home run number 55 on the year. It's 1-0. 8 straight games with a home run.
They'll tie in some great hitters at the plate. Griffey, Mattingly, Dale Long. This is just impressive. Big part of the yard for that home run and just barely got it over the wall. I thought for a second he brought it back out there too. Gave it a great effort, but you know those plays are so tough to pull off. And I'm sure he'd love to have another shot at.
All set for the start of the inning. And now the Pirates leadoff man, David Shartner. Swing and a ground ball out to short. And he beats the throw, shows off the wheels right there, an infield single.
Boom, that's Stan with.
And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom four, and at the plate for Miami, Steven Tan. This one in the air, center field. Classe gets under it. And there's one down.
He was all over that first pitch fastball. Now just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready.
We go to the top of the fifth, and now it's going to be Jonathan Classe.
You got this guy.
Classe, in his 9th season, 32 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Kicks and deals. Bounced out to short. Oh, he gloves it. From his backside, he's in there.
The effort from both players involved in this play just really stands out to me. I mean, you got the diving stop at short, which was outstanding, and how can you not love the hustle flying down the line? That's just great baseball at an extremely high level.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Steven Tan.
Swing and a ball hammered left field.
What? Go to.
And it hits the fence. One run across around third. The relay. And he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. One out, base is empty. Donnell Corona, the next Pirate to hit. One down, base is empty. Up the middle. Tan throws the first in time.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
On the ground to the left, Tan gets it to first, and that is the third out of the inning. Make it 6 shut. And we're back, ready for the bottom of the eighth. And now, Steven Tan.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tie and run on base, but because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
This one driven deep, way back there, and it's gone. We are tied. He powers that one out of here. His 56th home run of the season, and we have a tie ball game. It's 4-4. The brighter the lights, the more he shines.
Yeah, this guy lives for big moments, and right there made a statement big time.
an incredible momentum swing on that home run, Boog. I mean, it's late in the game, just barely stayed fair, and it ties up the ball game. Impressive.
One down. Digging in, Steven Tan. This guy is one of the best athletes in the sport. On a line, base hit. Around third. The throw in. And he's in there as a run scores. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he's squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Here's the left fielder, Ryan Clifford. Second and third, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. These two offenses could put up runs in a hurry. Line drive, base hit. One run is in. Now two runs score, and it's an eight-run lead.
They are really feeding off each other. That's five hits in a row. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way. And a really nice three-game home series sweep. They came out and, you know, from the first game of this series, really had a determination to play fundamentally sound baseball. They came up with the big hit when they needed it. Pitchers came in. They got the big outs when they needed it. So all the way around,
here in Miami, Lone Depot Park, the show brings you game one of a huge four-game weekend set. It's the St. Louis Cardinals taking on the Miami Marlins. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaub. Steven Tan making waves in the baseball world right now after homering in eight straight games. A major league record shared by Dale Long, Don Mattingly, Ken Griffey Jr., and he's got a chance to match it today, Chris.
Well, Boog, runs like this pull people into baseball that aren't even necessarily baseball fans, because the excitement around every at-bat that he has, I'm sure a lot of people are going to be watching to see if he can tie that record in this one.
Ready to go? Here's the center fielder, Lou Hamlin.
The center fielder, Lou Hamlin.
Bounce to the left side. He's in there.
Batting second. Easton Valdez.
And here is Easton Valdez. 0-2 now. Hit on the ground, might be two. Fires to second for one. Back to first, and that is a double play.
I think 4-6-3 double plays like that are way tougher than these guys make it look sometimes, because no matter how you do it, the feed from the second baseman is a tough one. That's where footwork really comes into play.
But runner at first with two away. Steven Tan digs in now. That one is absolutely belted. And in one hops the wall. Flint around third. He'll score. It's 1-1. And that extends his hitting streak yet again. This is starting to get pretty interesting, Singy.
Yeah, and the way he's going, it seems like there's no end in sight. This is a guy that no pitcher wants to face right now, especially with runners on base. I mean, he's doing all the little things right, and it just seems like he's in cruise control at the plate.
Runner breaks for third. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. Second inning coming up here in South Florida. All tied 1-1. Man in scoring position with two away. Here's the left fielder, Bryce Warner.
Warner.
Bounced out to short, Tan. Throws to first in time. And they're happy to just get off the field after that frame. They get four runs on five hits, no errors, and leave one. We move on to the...
The batter, number one. Shortstop, Steven Tan.
Hey, let it fly.
That one ripped. And it's off the foul pole for a home run. It just got out of here. His 57th homer of the season, it's 7-4. Nine consecutive games with a home run.
Well, just dialed in at the dish right now. Nine games in a row, that's just unthinkable. Congrats to him. Well, he really crushed that thing down the line, and everyone had to hold their breath until it clanked off the pole. And every time that happens, it just kind of...
Back here in Lone Depot Park. To the batter now, Steven Tan. The pitch. Smoke to right center, and this one's gonna go out of here. Another homer. His 58th home run of the season. It's 12-5. Singy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Steven Tan. 3 for 3, he's got a double and a pair of home runs. Smoked on the ground a second. Throws to first in time.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch.
Tan, certainly not the reason they lost this game. Cracked a pair of homers.
I'll tell you, I was excited every time he came up. Even though he couldn't lift them to a win, he really made an impact. Great job in this one.
4 hours and 16 minutes.
Now it's the power speed combo, Steven Tan. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And that's a double.
All over that one right there. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
So two down. Eric Flint will hit next.
Batting four.
Two outs and one in scoring position.
Flint.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
The pitch. That one the other way. Brings it in for the third out. Marlon Strand a pair, scoreless after one. Lou Hamlin next up for the Cardinals.
Lou Hamlin.
And here it comes. On the ground, could be two. There's one.
Out.
And that's two. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. We head down to the home half of inning number three. No score. Soy yo estoy corto.